I'm Kylie Swisher, and I am a postdoctoral research associate with Joe Mooney-Naza at the USDA ARS Research Laboratory in Wapato, Washington. And I've been working on a study to assess the transmission of LSO haplotypes through seed potato. So there's been a lot of conflicting data on the significance of ZC tubers in the spread of the disease. And so what I've been looking at, or what factors could contribute to this, is that different LSO haplotypes, different psyllid haplotypes, or even different potato varieties. And so I've taken on a very large study to look at this, 8 different potato varieties with 10 different treatments, so 3 different psyllid haplotypes with either LSOA, LSOB, or a combination of LSOA and B. And so what we want to do is look at the disease severity of these tubers that are produced and then and yield, and then from there take these tubers, plant them out the next year, and look at the emergence, the daughter tubers, the yield, and the ZC incidence. And so we've done some preliminary data on this, and it definitely looks like ZC tubers emerge slower. They are probably 3 times slower at emerging compared to asymptomatic tubers, and they also have a much lower emergence rate. So we also have looked at the LSO in the plants that are emerging from these disease tubers, and we see a small percentage that are positive for the bacterium. What's interesting is that out of these positive plants, significant a number of them are showing healthy healthy foliage. So we're not seeing the typical ZC symptoms, even though they're testing positive for LSO. So we've looked at yield. It doesn't seem to be a difference in yield between the disease tubers and healthy tubers. And we've also looked at the daughter tubers as far as ZC severity. We're not seeing zebra chip being produced. So that's preliminary data, and hopefully after a year, I'm excited for what we will have looking at all the different LSO and psyllid combinations.